to 20. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything to stand, stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayer and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. Pray for me also, that whenever I open my mouth, words may be given me, that I may fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearlessly as I should. The word of the Lord to his Spirit. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master key. Jesus started with prayer and ended with prayer. Prayer is the master key, is the master key. Achieve within the year. But for us Christians, Our resolutions are best achieved when we do so in communion with God. When we place our plans, our prospects, our expectations, aspirations in the hands of God. Like our brother James will say in James chapter 4 from verse number 13 to 15, he says, it will be pride to say tomorrow and next I will do this or that, without saying if the Lord wills it, if the Lord permits. And so for us, when we set our plans, we don't set our plans to achieve them by our own strength. We set our plans believing that the one who strengthens us is with us. As Paul will write to the Philippians and say, I can do all things by the power of him who strengthens me. Also acknowledging the word of God in John chapter 15 verse 5, that apart from him, we can do nothing. And that is the reason, my dear friends, that as we begin our year as a church family with our adoration, in a special way, our monthly program of prayer and restoration, it'd be good to present before God once again all those beautiful ideas and agendas that we have agreed on as part and parcel of our project this year, which we termed our New Year resolution. When we do so, we do that in expectation of the promises of the scriptures, that whatsoever we agree, two or three of us, and acts of the Lord shall be granted unto us. In Matthew chapter 18, verse 18 and 19. And that is the reason when we gather this way, we don't pray just for ourselves. We pray for the community. And we pray in agreement. That is why we all left our homes, because we believe that Jesus is here with us. And we have an appointment with him. And what we unite and ask of the Lord is granted unto us. And that is the reason I was motivated in the spirit to reflect this evening on Paul's letter to the Ephesians chapter 4, chapter 6 from verse number 10 to 20. To call each and every one of us to a life, a more committed life of prayer throughout this year. As we listen to that reading, verse 18 and 19 says, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayer and requests. Pray on all occasions. Can you help me tell someone around you, please pray on all occasions. Praying on all occasions. Those of us who are conversant with the things of the scripture, Ephesians chapter 6 is one of those passages of the scripture in the New Testament that you cannot just walk across without stopping over to reflect. Because it deals with something, a theme that is strong and is a bone of contention for all we do in humanity, even when we do not realize it. What do I mean? In Ephesians chapter 6, after Paul had discussed every other beautiful thing, Ephesians begins by saying, blessed be the Lord and God of our Father Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing. And he says a beautiful hymn about what Jesus has achieved in our lives, beginning from verse 1. And he did all manner of teachings. But at the last chapter, chapter 6, Paul gets into something that he started by saying, finally. He talked about Christian unity. He talked about the gifts of the Holy Spirit. He lectured us on doing the will of God, on departing from the old way in order to live the new life, on not giving the devil opportunity through anger, and on forgiving one another as Christ, God has forgiven us in Christ. But in chapter 6, he dealt a little with family life and then said, finally, to summarize everything I have taught you, say, be strong in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Be strong in the Lord. He said, this is the only way you will be able to resist the evil day. My dear friends, we have 365 days, and all of them are not rosy. And one evil day can spoil the joy of the rest 364. And that is why the Bible says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the devil's scheme, because every year we set in, we have set in to struggle, to work hard. And in working hard, we battle through things. We war not just flesh and blood. The things we encounter as human beings does not just end in the physical. That's what Paul is saying. Most of the time, we limit our expectations and our battles to the physical. And it is only defective because every human being is a composite of spirit and body. Incidentally, our world emphasizes more what it sees and what it can touch, which is the physical, the transient, the bodily. And these things pass away. The real thing that matters, that is the spiritual, is not given enough emphasis in humanity. When we talk about success, we emphasize only efforts, our physical efforts, forgetting the fact that the world in which we are is a world of body and spirit. And that the spiritual controls the physical. Most of the time we see only the physical, and that is what appears to matter for us. But beyond this physical, there are things happening in the spiritual. Even when we do not take it serious as Christians, those who are not Christians, especially those who are given to occultism and those who serve the evil one, know that there is a current beyond the physical. And they plan themselves and prepare themselves to combat with those who are coming from the kingdom of God. Incidentally, Jesus warned that the sons of this world are more astute in dealing with their kind. They plan ahead, unlike the sons of the kingdom. That is the reason Paul decided to call us, to call our attention to the spiritual battle that is on and that is raging in the life of every Christian and in the world. Though we may not notice it, though we may not take cognizance of it, and the devil likes it, the Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. When we do not know that things are happening in the spiritual, we only fight the physical battle, not knowing that most of the things we are fighting in the physical have their roots in the spiritual. And that is the reason it would be nice for us to sit down in the presence of Jesus and discuss issues with Him. Mary knew how to do that. Martha was only busy with the physical. And Jesus told Martha, you toil about too many things. Only one is important, and Mary has chosen that part. And in calling attention to that, Paul marshaled out what he called the whole armor of God, the full armor of God, describing this Roman soldier. I am not taking you to spiritual warfare. That's a different thing altogether. But I am calling your attention to, after Paul would have taught the people of God what it means to be a soldier, because we are soldiers of Christ. Classical theology in the Catholic Church teaches us that we are the church militant. The church is theatrical. We are the church triumphant, who are in heaven. We are the church suffering, who are in purgatory, who are passing through the stage of purgation, heading towards heaven. But then we are the church militants. We are facing the battle. That is why we are called the church militant. But how military is the church in our time? Paul says, put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to resist on the day of evil.